So I'm telling you now, you move with a purpose. We lost a soldier last year here, a beautiful dancer. And the only thing we could do was walk. We did not play. We did not sing. Peace be still. Yes. So with all of this, I ask that in your stillness, in your meditative thought, in your humbleness, you walk with me, you carry your joy, you carry your triumph, and let's do this. Y'all ready?
Let's do that.
Yeah.
This festival will serve as a gateway. And when that gateway is opened, it allows for everybody to have the benefits of what the people inside the gate were benefiting from all along. To show them that there's a gateway that we are going to open up that will never be closed again. And all of us will be able to benefit from the things that just a segment of the population has been benefiting from.
And I particularly want to talk to my Black brothers and sisters as we continue to deal with the effects of systemic racism. I still want to talk about the hope we have. Fannie Lou Hamer said, I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. But at the same time, Fannie Lou Hamer had the resolve to continue to press forward, to continue to pursue, continue to fight.
It's still a dangerous place to be ill. It's a particularly dangerous place to be ill if you're Black. So while I cannot speak in any formal way for the American healthcare system, let me use my voice to apologize for the indignities, the disparities that are laden upon this community, the Black community. I am sorry, so, so sorry.
Laid her hands on my temple and solved what Western medicine could not. My mother knows the power of unconditional love.
I had such an amazing experience at the festival. I was so grateful for a space to channel that loss, especially as it was pretty immediate. My mother passed September 8th. We were battling cancer. Could I bring improv? Could I bring poetry? You want me to teach a workshop too? Like, I love that. Like, it's so much fun for me to create and just be with other folks and in community, and particularly to have a space to talk about transforming the relationship with the people that we care about the most. And so it was really important to me to be there, and it was so very special.
It's important that the community that you all are visiting today, this Leimert Park, for me, that we keep it culture, because this is the only place we have to heal. This is the only gathering spot we have for miles and miles around where Black people come and get together.
A few years later, when I was 19 years old, I was shot 5 times by a Pittsburgh police officer. In the case of mistaken identity, where I had lost my ability to walk. That loss and those losses really made me appreciate life. We're here this week, to dive deeper into the loss, to the life and love. Each and every last one of us in here experienced some type of loss, and we have a lot of life to live. So we have to be very intentional of how we live life. And from my lived experience, the best way to live life is living with love. I cannot teach what I do not know. I cannot lead where I will not go. I am my brother's keeper. I am my sister's keeper. And I am destined for greatness. Because I attract what I am. In the African language, we say ashe, ashe, ashe. Thank you.
What's a good day? Today was a good day, y'all. Today was a good day.
Today was a good day.
Tomorrow's my promise, so hey.
Today was a good day. Oh, today was a good day. Oh, today was a good day.